welcome to our video this week. This video is going to walk us through our lesson this week, in which we're going to be using some images from NASA's satellites in order to determine the factors that affect biodiversity and populations. So the objective for this lesson is big and wordy. Now let's break that down. One is to plan and conduct experiments. We're going to use the NASA Earth observation. The next part, use mathematical representations. We're going to be analyzing some images using this program called ImageJ, and then using that data in Excel. The last step, to support and revise explanations based on evidence. And all of this is tying this idea of biodiversity together. The first website that we're going to be using is called NASA Earth Observations, NEO. There are all these tabs, and as you click on each one, it'll bring this drop-down menu of all of these different data sources, which are images of various information. So if we pick something like chlorophyll concentration, it'll bring up a map, and you can learn more information about it by scrolling down and reading this section about this data set. The first tab that's open is basic, and it has the information written in a very straightforward, simple to understand way, so you can read about how they collected this data and what it means. If you understand what this information means, you can read the intermediate, or if you really want to learn some specific information, you can go to the advanced tab and read about what this map shows. Now, this map shows the entire world. You might, in your research, use data from the entire world, but there'll also be ways to zoom in to specific regions in order to be more specific about what your claim about biodiversity is. What I would really like you to focus on is looking for changes and being able to measure changes in whatever factor you choose from up here and see if they are connected with some other change. See if two bits of data are correlated or connected in some way. To gather additional information, I recommend that you go to my website. I have a lot of links set up. So this is the homepage. You'll want to click on biology. It'll bring up all the homework. Scroll down to the satellite project page. And on here are the links of everything that you'll need. So we have the link to the NASA Earth Observations website that we were just on, as well as a bunch of other information like project overview, the ImageJ software that we're going to be using, where we're going to be collecting our data, and some extra helpful links to info and resources down at the bottom. The goal for this lesson, again, is to determine factors that affect biodiversity. Now, in order to do that, you're going to have to learn some information about what you're looking at. What I recommend is that you use these helpful links in order to find additional information. I want you to be able to explain what affects biodiversity, what has caused biodiversity to change. So part of the project requirements is for you to be able to look at one set of data and be able to explain how that data is connected to some other event. For example, you might be looking at how climate change has affected sea ice, what has caused increased or decreased amount of rainfall, what causes more carbon monoxide to be produced in the air. So next, let's look at the ImageJ software that we'll be using in order to analyze our data. It doesn't look like much, it's just this little bar right here. The first thing that you'll want to do is to open up an image, a file, in ImageJ. To do that, go to File, Open. Once you have an image loaded, you will need to set the scale. In order to do this, you'll need to know the distance between two points on your map. To do that, I'm going to use Google Maps. So you want to zoom out and scan over until you're at a location that is similar to a location on your map. I'm going to choose the distance between Sierra Leone and this corner of Brazil, and I'm going to measure that distance. So I right click, go to measure distance, select one point, click, grab the other side, and bring it all the way over here to the other point right there. In this project, we're going to be using kilometers. So I'm going to write down this number right down here, 2938 kilometers. I'm then going to go back to my map here, select the line tool, and draw the same line. Once that line is on there, I can go to analyze, set scale, and in the known distance, enter that same information. 2, 9, 3, 8, and my units is kilometer, and hit OK. Now this entire map has been set for my one scale. Next, in order to analyze the image, I just want to select the area where there is a map, not all this extra information over here. So I'm going to use the square tool and select a square that's just contains my image, and go to image, crop. And now I just have the image that I want to analyze. So the next step is to analyze the image. What you're going to be looking for is specific colors in the map that you've chosen. Those colors will represent something, which you will be able to describe based on the chart of the map that you originally downloaded. In our graph here, I want to know what area is covered by this darker orange or red region, which is the warmest ocean surface temperatures. First, you'll need to make sure that the image is in the right type. Go up to Image, go Type, and select RGB Color. Now we'll be able to analyze the color of the specific areas by going to Image, Adjust, Color Threshold. I'm going to adjust the hue down to just the area that I want to select. So by moving these bars, you can see I'm selecting a tiny little patch of colors that are just this red region right here. It's very important that you select the same threshold for all of your images. So write down on your paper so you can do that the same for every image. Once you have your area selected, you'll want to hit select, and then that just selects this region and highlights the area that you selected in the image threshold. All the other pixels in this image are not going to be selected. The next step will be to analyze and measure that area, and it just gives a number. That number is in square kilometers, so you'll want to write it down, but be careful because there are no commas. What this is saying is that there is 15,912,092 square kilometers of water temperature that was in that red region on the original scale. Continue to do this same process for all the other images I've selected to analyze. The next step is to use a spreadsheet like Excel in order to analyze all the data that you've collected. This is an Excel sheet that I've already put together as an example. I was analyzing an image from August of 2000 versus August of 2010. The interesting thing about Excel is that once you enter in all your raw data in each cell, when you want to get an average, all you have to do is type in equals average and then select the boxes that you want to average, and Excel will do it for you. Another part of the analysis of this data is to figure out standard deviation. You'll be able to type in equals STDEV and then select the boxes that you want to analyze. And what that's doing is figuring out how much variation there is in the measurements. It's telling you how similar all of these numbers are to each other. And you want similar numbers in order to make a good, accurate comparison. So you'll want to compare the two averages over the two times. And this will show you how much change there's been. Obviously, in this example, you can see that the amount of area that had warm waters went from 12 million to 15 million, which is a large change. I'll want you to graph this data in order to better show your results. The final step, once you get all of your information together, is to make a final explanation and claim. To do that, you guys will be making a PowerPoint, and on my website, I have a link to a project template which you can use, which will walk you through all of the information that you'll need to include in your project. In this final step, you'll actually be able to make a claim that explains why you saw the change that you did in your data. You'll be able to explain what factors affect biodiversity. And that's all for now. I'll leave you with the song today, so click right down here if you want to listen to the full thing. And as always, be ready to ask some great questions.
This is Apollo Control at 102 hours into the flight of Apollo 11. It's grown quite quiet here at Mission Control.